Hello everyone, this is Yuna Mar with Messages of Nature and Beyond. Very welcome everybody. I just made a video and thought it was going to rain again, but I can see even a bit more sun coming out. And I've got some energy left, so yes, an inspiration. So I'm going to make another video. I want to talk about resources, about twin flame lookalikes and things that are happening between twin flames right now. And I want to speak about blame and some more things. And the birds, of course. So let's first speak about the twin flames, because it comes up in me many times and then something else comes. So for you who are true twin flames, you will know it by now. You will start to look alike more, and you will start to notice you're eating the same foods, or you crave the same foods as the other one is eating, even when you do have no, when you have no idea what the other one is eating or what they like, and you may not have understood why you crave certain foods. And also, your twin flame will influence you in many things, not only in the same posture, in the same, you can even have some nervous tics or pains in the body that you're feeling now, just as the twins in the human body, the twins in the soul body, mirroring each other and also feel each other's pains and joys and all of it. So I felt a bit heavy energy the last days, and then suddenly everything was feeling better and lighter again. And I'm sure my divine masculine has also felt that change, and we influence each other. So I'm very happy and grateful that to know my divine masculine is in a better place at this moment. And I'm receiving that nice energy with a big joy and gratefulness. And then I want to speak about, if you are blaming another for anything at all, small or big things, just see where actually you're doing it yourself. So instead of reacting, respond. Just take a deep breath. In general, when you breathe slower, when you slow down, as I told in another video, what I have to remind myself of often too, slow down, and then so much more inspiration, information, messages can come up. You start to connect with the earth, with your soul, with your higher self more. Your mind can think clearer because it gets more oxygen. You calm down, you get out of that adrenal stimulation of fight and flight response. So yes, of course, it's better to leave the white sugars, the Coca-Cola, coffee, caffeine stories behind. Just drink tea, green tea instead, or some lemon juice. If you like the cola taste, just use some clove and bergamot extracts, because that's the secret of the taste. But in general, you crave certain things, not only because, of course, with the twin flames, or when you're a human twin, your twin is craving that certain things. But, and from a human twin, it's easily to grow out of that pattern the more you move away from each other physically. But it's the same with the twin flames. If they move away physically, it's easier to disconnect in a greater sense than when you move towards each other, or when you are closer in proximity with each other. Your body start to get more excited, and everything is like you start to see each other everywhere stronger, and feel like they can walk every moment within your home or your city. Or you get exciting much more, not only when they physically are closer to you, but also when they start to thinking about you and opening their heart to you more. You can feel you get an exciting, and especially when they're in a joyful place, you start to feel in a joyful place as well. This is a beautiful process. Not sure where the blaming came up, but it was just an inspiration to speak about. So I know it is meant for certain people who are listening to hear this now or later, because you can listen to these messages in any time that you come across them. So are they being shared to you? So yes, yeah, start all the time when you reflect something. Start to reflect within. This is the real meaning of reflection. Alright? The reflection in the mirror is not just in that physical mirror, but it is in human beings, in animals, in the nature. They show you things. I've been doing workshops, for example. I've always been inspired by the Native American people, the Lakotas especially, because they have such a beautiful rituals and ceremonies connected with the nature. So I used many of those inspirations to program my workshops with. One of those were of course medicine walks and nature walks and ceremonies with the 12 stones and also crystals within, to help connect with the soul self, nature more, and feel that you're connected with all and receive love from so much more directions and information. But because of the shields they make, I was making paintings with canvas from the natural canvas that we make in a circle, and then with either olive or willow twitches, branches, stitch it around, tighten it, and then we paint it, preferably with natural paint, with your own totem, the animal, the color, and the element that at that moment came to you. Why did I do that? Because the entresol, and of course I was helping them in a meditation to see and know their own qualities to make the painting with, but the entresol would help them to expose or come forward a certain soul quality or personality quality, what needs to be brought in light or in harmony, or just will bring harmony and more empowerment in any way, shape or form. So we can do in so many ways: listening, slowing down, absorbing information. It is also very much appreciated for people when they are not anymore listening to the media, because just know that whenever you need information, it will come to you anyway from people that you know, or you will just suddenly come to it more with your intuition. The life with your intuition now is guided to be a better place for you, to live with your intuition. So you will be guided to the information you need to know and hear at that moment. But if you still feel drawn to go towards that third matrix and the media and all of the stuff, what's happening, if you need to know stuff, you can go in it. But it's advisable to just go in it only for a brief moment and then go back in your higher vibes, because you will learn so much more at this moment in the higher vibrations. You already learned all you need to learn in the lower vibrations. This is a new game, so embrace it and be excited about it and look forward to it, because it will bring you so much abundance and so many riches and so many joys and so many excitement and new experiences. You cannot even start to imagine that again. Oh wow, is that really blue sky? I mean, I'm spoiled. I have more than 300 days a year sunshine and blue sky, but you know, I grew up in a country where it was almost raining, always raining. So yeah, I feel quite lost when it's all gray and rainy. I really love the sun. It's my friend. It always helps me to activate myself, my body. It costs so much energy for me to warm myself when there is rain, and not in the summer. I don't mind rain in the summer, but in the winter when it's already cold. And then it's so somber, you know, the leaves fall from the tree. Like I'm blessed because I have many, many trees that just stay green all year. But for example, the pomegranate, as you see, they don't have leaves. But anyway, so distracting. Yeah, for myself, it's really beneficial to have the sunshine to get energy from. And I think it counts for many of us. And I believe that people talked a lot about the warming up of the planet. I think it is good. The ozone layer gets thinner because we are becoming a galactic citizen, and all these beneficial energies need to be able to penetrate us that are flooding in from the cosmos. And as well, I think the entire planet Earth needs to be warmed up so everywhere can grow the trees and also be equalized and more harmonized, so it will not be so excessive hot and excessive cold at some areas. So yeah, in enormous big places like the desert can start to grow trees, and also in the Antarctica. And the axis of the Earth has been influenced not only by places being frozen but also by metals being placed there, what is being removed, being collected, being placed to make some places heavier and some places lighter. I mean, the axis has been manipulated in any way, shape or form. It doesn't matter how. And what matters is that it is being restored and the Earth will turn into her rightful place again. Which reminds me of a song I made, which is happening. Oh yes, I'm going to play the Twin Flame song that I wrote in 2010 when I did hear about the Twin Flame name with no idea what it meant other than it could be kind of romantic way of saying it is my forever love, my true love, but I had no idea what it truly meant. And also not that I would have a Twin Flame, although I always felt and craved that I had that one special one. But the real story I didn't know yet. I just only knew it last year when my twin flame finally found me. And I was completely and entirely stimulated, excited in every pore of my being. Not physically just, but in my brain, in my emotion, in my soul, everywhere. Everywhere. We had done a lot of astral traveling, etheric traveling. That stopped because we merged and it's not needed. We have the telepathy, we feel each other. And I think my divine masculine is becoming aware of that more and more himself as well. And also, if you're listening, my divine masculine, I know direct communication is not really preferable at the moment until you feel ready, but it doesn't matter. You probably won't hear this if it's not meant for you to hear. But I just want to say, these and many other messages and things that I'm doing is also you doing it. We're doing it together and you helped me so much. You have helped me so much. Dear beloved people, my divine masculine has helped me so much in so many ways that he is not aware of. And I would love him to be aware of it because he needs to know and feel what a great, gorgeous soul he is. And he soon will know because all of the divine masculines on our planet are awakening now, which is worth a big huge celebration. Really we are going to be in reunion, all of us, with celebration and harmonic sounds and everything that's delightful. And yes, all right, let me stop talking. See you next time, because I'm going to say some crazy stuff now if I think too much about my divine masculine. So yeah. Alright, I keep that between us for now. So anyways, people, sensual strength, positivity, empower yourself, become your own healer, move away from all the doctrine and all of the false matrix programs that have kept you away from empowering yourself, knowing the power you have over your body and the enormous power that your body has to heal itself, to bring itself in balance, but also to be your instrument, to not only channel your own higher soul energy in, but also the cosmic soul energy and Earth Mother Soul, magnificent Earth. her energies and all around you. So the birds, the elements, the elementals, every creature that comes to you has a message to tell you. If you want to reach out for a session with me one-on-one to bring you clarity, to help you know better what's going on, and also to delete a soul contract, binding soul contract, any vows, black magic, any attacks of the negativity, not serving you, of course. If you want to know more about your past lives and heal them, heal your soul fragments, anything that you want to know about people that have been passing, that you feel something still needs to be said or resolved, anything you want to know about yourself, your soul, your life, for clarity, and to help you empower yourself, please contact me. You're very welcome. My prices are different. How do you say it? Fluctuate depending the timelines we are in. But also, no, I wanted to talk about resources, because we are spending many things, but spending. It's better if you buy yourself rich. What does that mean? To buy things that are beneficial to your health, to your well-being, to your growth, to your evolution, to your expansion. So instead of wasting and spending, it's better to expend and use your money wisely and carefully, and all of your abundance that has been sent to you or that you're working for. If you're still working the 8 to 5 hours, see if that is still beneficial for you, or time to let go of and to find a new direction. The things that you have been guided towards intuitively, it is very beneficial for you to listen to and to act towards, because it will be beneficial and greatly successful. And yeah, and so much more. See you in the next message. The sun is shining through, baby, for all of us. The golden age, the golden vibrations, the golden rays within us. Heal your solar plexus, heal all of your chakras, align with your true purpose, divine mission, and love you so much in my soul and unconditional love. I cannot say I love everybody personally, but unconditional love, yes, definitely. All right, speak to you soon. Bye-bye. I chose a new spot for you to record my videos. I hope you like it. Watching my avocado trees and some birds and blue sky. Enjoy. Growing your own food. Hey, birdie.
sound that sounds like a dog, but it isn't. It's a parrot that thinks he's a dog. It is true. It is a gorgeous, sweet parrot that is barking. On the background, you are hearing the sea.
Right, see you soon, be beautiful people. Bye bye.